Welcome back. It's time to check in with Jill Welke over at WAX to see what's happening in the crop and agriculture world. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning.
How was your weekend?
It was busy.
Oh, okay.
It was busy, from processing cows and calves to a wedding to a family gathering. And I didn't even get a nap this weekend.
Okay, I'm tired, man. For you.
Well, and I don't tell jokes like Kristen.
That's okay.
But I like the brain teasers.
Okay, do you have one?
So this is what I've got for you. Right. A cowboy rode into town on Friday. He stayed 3 nights and rode out again on Friday. How is this possible?
The horse's name was Friday.
Well, goodness gracious, you guys are way too quick for me. You are right.
Okay, I'm still processing, so actually, you know.
I'll explain to you, Bob.
Yeah, I got it. The horse is named Friday. Yep.
Okay, and I got one more for you.
Okay.
What is full of holes but still holds water?
A sponge?
Man alive, you are just spot on this morning. I don't know. I'm going to have to go back to the drawing board and do a little bit better for you guys, I guess.
She put her thinking cap on.
I do.
This
I love trivia, so I put on my thinking cap. So.
Well, I guess I should have taken a different avenue for you, but. You know, you never know when I come back on a Monday what I'll have for you.
Exactly. Okay.
Well, that was good.
Yeah,
I
was good.
That.
I like the brain teasers.
My brain has been teased.
Well, we better jump into some farm news. Well, the sale of raw milk finally became legal in Iowa on July 1st. It took nearly 2 decades of discussions before legislation was passed that allows farm-to-consumer sales of raw milk in liquid form to be legal. Legislators label the bill as a people's bill that allows neighbor-to-neighbor transactions, not a producer's bill. It does not cover large producers. The law does allow small farms that have less than 10 cows, to be able to meet a niche demand where consumers buy shares of a cow. Each share then entitles them to 1 gallon of raw milk each week. Consumers also pay a monthly boarding fee for every share they own to help pay for the care of that cow. Farmers in Iowa who are selling raw milk follow strict protocols to ensure the milk that is sold is safe for human consumption. And proposals of sales of raw milk in Wisconsin have been discussed for the past 15 years, but have not been passed. So Wisconsin does not allow on-farm sales of raw milk. And a week ago, there was an explosion at ADM's Decatur, Illinois processing plants, which is ADM's largest facility. Last week on Monday, ADM confirmed the East plant was down, and it produces soybean oil and white flake for soybean protein production. ADM's corn processing plant, which is also on the same site, was also temporarily down, with the company saying it is working to safely resume operations. The corn processing plant is one of the largest wet corn mills in the world. And according to AgWeb Farm Journal, 8 people were injured, with 6 taken to the hospital. And as of last Tuesday morning, 5 ADM employees were still in the hospital. A fire did break out because of the explosion, but was brought under control very quickly. The cause of the explosion is still being investigated. And on a little lighter note, 4 finalists have been selected for the 2023 Wisconsin Leopold Conservation Award. This award is given in honor of conservationist Aldo Leopold. It recognizes farmers and forest land owners who are dedicated to conserving their land, water, and wildlife habitat. A finalist from our area is Knowles Dairy Farm in Alma in Buffalo County. Soil and water conservation has been practiced by the Knoll family for generations. They grow cover crops, utilize no-till and contour strip cropping to prevent soil erosion on their farm, which is overlooking the Mississippi River. The Knoll family has restored and manages dry bluff prairie, which is home to many endangered species. And their managed forest provides oak timber production and wildlife habitat. Congratulations to the Knoll Dairy Farm as a finalist for the 2023 Wisconsin Leopold Conservation Award. And today is the start of National Farm Safety and Health Week, which I think should be every day of the year and every week of the year. AgriSafe Network is hosting webinars all week focused on keeping our farmers and farm workers safe throughout this harvest season. These programs will also be available on their website following their initial webinar. Let's slide on over to our markets. December corn is sitting at $4.77, up a penny and a half. December wheat's at $5.99, down 4.5 cents. And November soybeans are sitting at $13.40 with no change from last week. Barrel cheese, $1.81, down a penny. Block cheese, $1.88, down 4 cents. And gray AA butter, $2.71¾, down 2.5 cents. And our class 3 milk futures, September, $18.40 with holding steady. October, $18.10, down 15 cents. And November, $18.33, that one is also holding steady from last week. And that's what I have for news and markets for this beautiful Monday morning. Looking forward to a beautiful week this week.